Buddy, it's Vervain. We are at Universal Studios waiting to get into the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. This is my mom. You're gonna wave to my people. They love you. They always want to meet my mom. This is my brother on the ground here, looking at a map. And we are in, and we are running to the Hogwarts ride because we hear that the lines only get way worse throughout the day. So we're going to Hogwarts. I think we need to go to the right a little bit of this tower. Oh, wait. Where are we going?
Well, it's kind of straight ahead, slightly to the right, and then to the right. Oh, then that's
a wonderful day.
No footage of this ride because we have to put all our things away in a locker, but you get to see this part. Okay, that was an amazing ride. If you don't know anything about it, it's like mostly simulation in these domes with projections and like a simulation ride, but then it also takes you like through replicas of parts of Hogwarts in the grounds. It's really, really cool. Highly recommend it. However, I kind of think the line maybe was the best part, and because we got here so early, we just zoomed right through the line, and there's so much going on in the line that I really want to go back through and do it again later when there is more of a line. And we're gonna be here all day, so that won't be a problem. We are now getting in line for the Hippogriff ride, which I've heard is not as good of a ride, and if the line's really long, not to bother with it, but
there's nothing that lives in the forest that'll hurt you. If you're with me, you're fine.
But there's no line, so. And we're here all day, so like, why not? Let's do it. Oh, look, Sirius's motorcycle. Hagrid's hut.
Have Jess's hut.
No, we will. My mother is the same kind of crazy that I am in the best possible way. So she actually made these, and John wants chocolate now. So here we are.
Albus
Dumbledore.
Oh, you got Albus Dumbledore?
I did.
There we go. Albus Dumbledore. How is it, John? And she made these. These are every good flavor. That's the benefit of putting it together yourself. The banana, tutti frutti. Oh, can I have the popcorn?
Sure. Usually I like this color. We'll see.
We are in line for Ollivander's. Look at that Hogwarts castle in the background. And we're gonna do the wand experience, but I don't know if any of us will get chosen or not. We are definitely like the most dressed up people in line.
Oh yeah.
Which is kind of surprising to me. But we are like a whole family of dressed up people, and we're surrounded by muggles. We are still in line for Ollivander's, but we are getting close to the front. I have a good feeling about all this. We're literally right at the front of the line now. It is our group at the very front. We deserve to get picked. We deserve it. We've been in the game so long, guys.
Hello, witches, wizards.
Hi, welcome. Come right this way, but stay with your group against this wall. Fill all this available space, sure to witches and wizards in the front, taller towards the back. Remember, filling all the available space for me, folks. Shorter witches and wizards, do come forward for me.
Welcome to Ollivanders, makers of fine wands. I am the wand keeper, and you've all come here to witness a wand fitting. Are you two here together?
We are.
Are you here for your wands?
We are.
Wonderful. Please step into the light. Let me see you more clearly.
What the hell? How amazing is this? They picked me and my mother? What? Usually they pick one 11-year-old kid. They pick 26-year-old me and my mother. Clearly, by the way, the two most excited people in the room. Our whole family was in costume. My mom and I were literally bouncing up and down. My mom pulled a full Hermione and rose her hand out of, like, nowhere when they weren't even, like, picking people yet. And I just feel like, I don't know, my mom and I got into Harry Potter together, guys. We've been on this road for a long time. She threw me literally 5 insane Harry Potter birthday parties. I got into Harry Potter by stealing the first Harry Potter book out of her purse at one of my dentist appointments. And, like, I don't know, it just, it feels so right. It feels like we're coming full circle, and I hope no one else in that line feels like they really missed out because we got chosen, but I feel like that was the most perfect thing that could have happened for us.
What are your names?
Vervain.
Yes.
Carmen.
It's a pleasure to meet you both. Now, which are your wand arms, left or right? Both right? Yes. Could you hold them out like this for me and come much closer, please? Thank you so much. A wand of holly. It's 15 inches long, nice and supple, with a dragon's heartstring core. I'd like you to take this, dear. Now let's try a spell, shall we? Oh yes, I'd like you to water those flowers up there. Now, just give your wand a wave and say, Aguamente.
Aguamente.
Nicely done. Very good. Oh, oh dear. That's not quite what we're looking for. So quite all right, not to worry. Yes. Yes, Aguamente! Well, you're very powerful. But that is definitely not your wand. Your turn, my dear. A wand of reed, also 15 inches long. It's rather bendy, with a... Oh, also a dragon's heartstring. Oh, yes. I'd like you to levitate one of those wand boxes up there. Now, just pick one. Give your wand a swish and a flick and say, Wingardium Leviosa.
Wingardium Leviosa.
There we are. Once again, very good try. It was a very good try. No, not to worry. Yes, Reparo. There we are. Well, getting closer, I think. Yes, you're both doing very well. Now, it's always been very clear to those of us studying wand lore that the wand chooses the wizard, but it's not always so clear as to why. Tricky customers, aren't you? If I may, perhaps admired by your friends. But remember, the wand learns from the wizard. And the the wizard from the wand. Well done.
Okay, we have not taken the wand keeper's advice, and we are getting this holly wand, which I will show you in a minute.
I don't know what I was on about there. Obviously, like I said, we did not follow the wand keeper's advice, so we did not get the holly wand. We got the hazel wand, and here it is. And I like it a lot. It feels really good in the hand. And yeah, no holly, hazel.
And it's going to be interactive, so we're going to show you some cool things throughout the park. Do some magic.
That is so much fun.
We are here at the Three Broomsticks. We have ordered the feast for us four to share. I got some pumpkin corn on my hand, pumpkin fizz, and we've got some frozen butter beer. And the feast.
Okay, here we go.
Feast your eyes on that before we feast on it. For anyone wondering, the chicken was perfectly cooked, moist, tender, delicious. The ribs were a little dry, but otherwise good. The corn was kind of bland, not really worth eating, but nothing wrong with it. Vegetables, same thing. Salad, kind of a sad excuse for a salad. Potatoes were perfect. Pumpkin fizz was very, very sweet, but still delicious. And the frozen butter beer was a fascinating experience. I'm glad I didn't get a whole thing, but I'm also glad I tried John's.
Books?
No.
Oh. I've always wanted to read Hogwarts a History. But it's oh no. This is a shame. I want to read them. This is all I've ever wanted, is the opportunity to cast spells with a magic wand that have instantaneous, cool, fun results, and they've created a world where I can do just that. This is like everything a tea witch could want. Alohomora.
And compass. You know, you see, and then you dance. A little victory.
right. We have just gone around making a whole bunch of spells happen and making things happen around this park. And we are about to have a drink at the Pog's Head.
Stout, lager, and a Scottish Red Ale.
Which one's the witch's brew?
The witch's brew is a coffee stout. And then the dragon scale is the red lager. Pog's Head is a medium body Scottish Red Ale.
I want to try the stout, the coffee stout.
The stout in the cup.
Alright, so we're at the Hogshead slash Three Broomsticks. They're kind of connected here, even though in the Harry Potter universe they're competing businesses. They're both pubs in Hogsmeade. Anyhow, and we got the Witch's Brew, which is a coffee stout in the Hogshead mug, which is only $2 more than getting it in a plastic cup, so kind of an obvious choice when you're already here. And it's pretty darn good, if you like coffee stouts.
Sweet.
Yeah, like everything here is very sweet. But it's nice.
Everyone, and welcome. We represent the Hogwarts School Choir. And we are here to share some music with you.
Boxes like this in the gift shop. I'm thinking hard about it, I'm not gonna lie. Oh, look at that! Oh, who did we get? Here's the frog. Who did we get? Godric Gryffindor. Godric Gryffindor, medieval, precise dates unknown. One of the four celebrated founders of Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry, Godric Gryffindor was the most accomplished dueler of his time, an enlightened fighter against Muggle discrimination and the best owner of the celebrated Sorting Hat. Fabulous.
I just saw this.
Wait, what?
It says Croco Solids, 70% minimum.
I don't know a spell to open this plastic, so we're gonna use a Sharpie pen instead. Chocolate frog, milk chocolate shaped frog. Of course, nobody buys it for the chocolate. Oh, look at that. Wow, this is a lot like the one you made. And then we've got the frog, carefully encased in food safe plastic. We got Birdie Bot! Oh my god. Did you see it? Birdie Bot! He invented Birdie Bot's every flavor beans, quite by mistake. His original purpose was to create tasty sweets from food. After an accident during his experiment, he recognized the sales potential of flavors that range from delicious to disgusting, including marshmallow, tutti frutti, grass, soap, and earwax.
Quick note, guys, it's now been 11 days since I dropped this $40 piece of mail in this here mailbox, and I'm starting to feel mighty suspicious about whether or not it's ever going to arrive at the Citrine Palace. That said, if it does arrive, it'll be pretty cool.
John's gonna try his hand at some spell work here at Honeydukes. Couple questions from viewers over the years about how, as someone who identifies as a real witch, how do I feel about Harry Potter and how magic is portrayed? And the answer to that question is, I love Harry Potter. I'm probably one of the biggest Harry Potter fans that you'll ever meet. This woman here enabled no less than five Harry Potter birthday parties over the years. And I think that Harry Potter is a great illustration of the concept. You go do it. A great illustration of the concept that however much magic you have, it's not as important as friendship and bravery and teamwork. And you know, like they say in the books, you know, the good guys have magic, but the problem is the bad guys have magic too. And you know, magic doesn't solve all your problems. It just creates new and different problems with new and different ways to solve them. And I think Harry Potter is a really great series of stories. I think it has a really great set of morals. I think anyone who says that it's devil worship has not read the Bible, because it's actually a very Christian story. Like, it's actually very much a Christ narrative, especially if you read all the way to the end of the series. It's very much a Christ narrative. Kind of funny, actually. And, yeah, I think Harry Potter's really great. And, I don't find it offensive at all as a real witch. I think it, you know, it doesn't portray real magic. Although actually, it does talk about the fact that the greatest magic of all is love. And if you ask Dumbledore, he says that music is a magic beyond all we do here at Hogwarts. So I think the books themselves show a great appreciation for the true magic that is in the world, beyond just the wand waving and spell casting. And yeah, so I think Harry Potter's really great. And also, this has been such a fun and enchanting day here at the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. It was absolutely ridiculously expensive. My mother has spoiled me, and I have spoiled myself, but a witch has gotta do what a witch has gotta do. I will have some more videos coming up. I will be making a haul video of all the things that I picked up during my time here at the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. I also sent myself a howler, a bit of a letter from my higher self to my future self, so I will be posting an opening of that when that arrives back at my domain, the Citrine Palace. And yeah, let me know if you guys have any more questions about my thoughts on Harry Potter. I'd be happy to film other videos on that. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you love Harry Potter as much as I do, or, you know, at all, let me know what's your favorite Harry Potter book, what's your favorite character, what's your favorite thing about Harry Potter, what's your favorite Harry Potter memory? That's maybe a better question. And I love you guys. I hope you all have a wonderful, magical day, and I'll see you all again very, very soon. Just don't forget to like and subscribe.